3 more minutes, and I'll hunt this thing off. Let me close by talking about spiritual sharing. Yes, Paul says, all right, now that you know what you know, and you have what you have, you can now receive the fullness of God. Look at somebody and say, the fullness of God. Wow, that's a powerful statement. I just told you how awesome God is. I just told you he can give you anything and everything. And then Paul got nerve enough to say you can have the fullness of God. Oh, wow, that blows my mind. But if that didn't do it, yes. The next verse sure got me when he said, now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us, unto him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end. Well, my brothers and sisters, Paul said you can have the fullness of God, but then he goes a step further and says, now unto this God who's able to do exceedingly abundantly above that which you ask or think. Notice he didn't say he can do more than you ask or think. He said abundantly more. He didn't just say it was a little bit more, but it's abundantly more. It's abundantly above. It's higher than what you can ask or think. For those who think you can manipulate your life, you can make yourself feel better. You positive thinkers who think that you can positively focus your mind and feel better, he says what God can do is more than what your manipulations can do. God does more than that. Whatever you think you can do, that still doesn't come close to what God can do. You will let go and let God. And maybe that's the problem. We got too many folk trying to do it themselves instead of letting the Lord have complete control. Stop trying to make yourself feel better and turn it over to the Lord. He will work it out. Stop lying to yourself and the Lord and admit when you're down in the dumps and say, Lord, here I am. I'm not feeling the way I should feel. I'm not talking the way I should talk. I don't feel on the inside the way I need to feel. The cliches aren't helping me. The songs don't relate to me. I need more than that, Lord. Have your way. Have your way. You are the potter, and I am the clay. Shape me and mold me after your will. And I decline to you, the Lord will step in on time. The Lord will come to your rescue. The Lord blow your mind. He'll do more than you can imagine. And I'm closing now. Let me tell you something. Not only does he do exceedingly abundantly, but you need to understand you miss the record when you think he does it all to you. See, folks want to shout right there because he's going to give me more than I think I'll receive. I'm going to be richer than he thinks that my mind can fathom. Now it's more than that. What God is saying, yes, when you let go and let God, God can then use you in kingdom building. When you let go and let God, God can use you to be a blessing. It's not about you, it's all about him. And when you let go and allow him to use you, he will do exceedingly abundantly above whatever you can imagine. Do you have a witness here? The Lord gave me the gift of preaching, and the Lord gave me the gift of teaching. But you see, I try to keep it to myself. it's not going to do any good. The only way the gift helps me is if I share it with you. But now when I share it with you, it's not mine anymore. But now it becomes yours. And what I gave you, now you can go and give it to somebody else. And I imagine how many lives I touch. It has nothing to do with who's sitting in the building. What you do with what you have, and God says, you can't measure what I'm doing in your life. You can't measure your own ministry, but if you let go and let me, you will do more than you can possibly imagine. You can do more than you ever had.
Thank you.
meet you next Sunday. So your pain gonna hurt your head. Then when our brother said, repent, you too can tell you the man to behave like you behave in the pulpit. You've been to college. Educated, you ought to behave better than that. The parents said, baby, I've been to college. But the only reason I made it through college is the Lord had me by my hand. I wish I had a witness here. But before I got to college, folks who couldn't read or write was motivating me and loving on me. Old ladies didn't even have a grade school education. Was crying when she thought I was going to quit college. And you think I'm going to come to church and be too sophisticated to have praise the Lord. The Lord had his hands on me. When I was 4 years old singing in the choir, the Lord had his hands on me. When I was growing up, had a piece of wood in my feet. I don't know how long. And the doctor said, you're supposed to be dead. I knew the Lord had his hands on me. And you think after God is going to fall and I got time to tell you about. I get here trying to look sophisticated.
Thank you.
Church.